Welcome back everybody to more Style Ladder Season 12 Europe action. We've got a big best of three here. Team Secret taking on Alliance in Phase 2 of the Europe and CIS division. These two teams currently yet to play any of their matches in their group stage. And we're going to see how things unravel here in their opening match. I'm Gods. Joining me for this best of three is none other than Evil Genius's captain, PPD. How you doing, PPD?
I'm doing very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. It's nice to get up in the morning, cast some good Dota here so far. We had Empire versus Aces Polar, and now we've got another big series. So we'll see how these two teams match up. They met in the Summit 3 in the winner bracket. It was Secret who took that series 2-0. They had like one close game there, but Alliance maybe learned something from that series and will do better here today.
Yeah, I think I remember like one of the games was like super epic and like people were going crazy about it or something. It was like a amazing comeback, but then like Secret ended up winning regardless. But
so we'll see what Alliance. Yeah, I mean, there's been a lot of big exciting games lately. I mean, even you guys yesterday against Not Today had a pretty close series in the end.
We had that in the bag the whole time.
me and LD were watching on the couch downstairs like, oh my gosh, it's game three. You guys are down like 8k gold lead.
Oh, Smash Sama.
But it was funny because the entire time, like, LD believed you guys had it the whole time. And I'm sitting there like, nah, man, I think Not Today have this. Like, 8k gold lead.
We played so many qualifiers. Every single qualifier that we play, like, always goes like three games. And it, like, gets super crazy. Like, I remember a year ago, we played like Star Ladders against like team, who was it, like NAR and Team Fire and stuff, and or like Team Liquid, and they would always just go like, even if like we were like the way better team,
yeah,
on paper, we'd still like go to like the very end and we'd like be losing and then we'd pull out some crazy victory. So, but yeah, anyways, we got a game here. Yeah. S4 Magnus,
you've got the Troll Warlord. Alliance go for a Wisp Queen of Pain. The Wisp pick, especially, something we're seeing slightly less of as of late, but we'll see how Alliance can fit this into their draft. I mean, Magnus Troll, is this just like a...
It's good. It's just good, man. I'm telling, like, first off, Troll and Juggernaut are like two insane heroes. Like, they're just... Everyone knows these heroes are ridiculous. And then you give them Empower, and they just turn into a whole new monster. And they're just... I'm not sure... I have yet to see this combination lose. Like, any one of these melee carries with Magnus Empower, it's too much damage. So...
Yeah.
We'll see how Alliance tries to negate that.
I mean, I think it was like Na'Vi who first used it. I feel like Na'Vi would have disbanded maybe even sooner, or had all these roster issues sooner if they didn't figure out this combo and how good it was. I feel like they stayed together just because they made the Mag Troll or the Mag Jug work with Havost and Dendi, but...
Yeah.
We'll see, yeah, like you say. So Alliance, what do you do to deal with this? Like, what is the answer? Or...
Oh, I'm guessing the wrong person, man. I have no idea.
You don't give Troll away.
Yeah, I've been trying to figure out how to beat this hero. I really have, and I figured out a couple things, but then like someone will just crush us with it, and then I'll just be like, maybe that wasn't the answer. So it's a work in progress, to say the least.
Okay. As for Queen of Pain, we're seeing some teams like Secret played at five games against Aces Polar the other day. I mean, what kind of makes this hero really strong and like a top pick for some of these teams like Secret and Alliance?
I think he's just like, he's a really good laner, and that's what a lot of this game is about, is lanes. The new blink with the 1300 range at level 1 is pretty cool too. That's a pretty big buff. Also, like, I'm not sure, I think S4 usually goes Orchid, but Sumel, when he plays it, he goes Yules, and like, Yules is like the best item in the game, and buy it on like any hero, it's pretty good. He's a really strong laner. His ultimate with the pure damage is really good too. It goes through BKB. That was a nice change for him as well. But yeah, it works well if you're just trying to secure your lanes.
So Alliance have picked up a tree. I'm wondering if this is going to be like the Treant Phoenix we sometimes see out of them. Could give them some big team fight here with the Overgrowth and Supernova. Something that you guys pulled out at DAC and had some good success with.
Yeah, it's definitely a possibility. I've seen Bucking Mad draft that a couple times. It's actually pretty good against... Treant's pretty good against Troll because you can stop the right clicks with your root. Also, Troll doesn't generally build a Manta. He usually only wants to get a BKB, and most Trolls don't want to get BKB very early, but he might need to this game if he wants to be effective against the Treant ult.
Secret going to pick up a Bane as one of their first two support heroes. Something we're not seeing all that much of. I think you've played a bit of Bane here or there, and
yeah, he's pretty hit or miss. I saw Cloud9 have a lot of success with him with Misery playing Bane, but he's like the best Bane or whatever, so okay. We'll see. It's probably going to be a puppy hero, I think. I don't think that really... Actually, no, I've seen Kuroki play it, too. I'm not sure.
Yeah, it seems there's a lot of supports left still in the pool, so it's interesting to see Secret go for this. There's not, like, any clear, like, BKB hero you're trying to lock down with Fiend's Grip. Not really any, like... Not, like, any synergy with, like, a Mirana or something with an arrow to follow things up, so... just to support that, maybe Secret are kind of starting to value a bit more over the past few days.
Maybe. Could also be he might run mid and Feeble Quap or something if they want to give their mid laner a better time, but I don't think Magnus should really need that help. He's just going to be using Shockwaves anyways.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Maybe they probably have a combo in line, like a... I'm not sure, maybe a Lushrak or something like that.
Yeah, just get
set
some...
up Sun.
Get some stuff. I mean, Queen of Pain's a pretty elusive hero, so like, while it's not like a BKB hero, it's still someone useful to lock down with a Fiend's Grip. And if you sit back, yeah, it's like, what's there to actually count? Well, the Clockwork had some counter to the Bane.
They might do Slark in the safe lane for Arteezy, and then just put S4 mid on the Troll Warlord and throw Zai on the offlane Magnus. If you have Bane Slark in a lane together, it's actually really strong. So, and the Slark will kill the Tree Armor right away too.
Okay. Yeah, they haven't got much for the Triama just yet, so we'll see. Alliance pick up a Clockwork as their offlaner for Niqua. Does give them some kind of good counter initiation, a way of maybe to go onto that Bane, and you lock Bane in place, he's not going to have fun against a Clockwork. But Magnus has got this Skewer Escape, and a hero that I feel some to me, I mean, you mentioned Bane being hit or miss. I feel Clockwork's in a similar boat. Like, some teams, like you guys, will sometimes pick him in the first two, but some games Clockwork looks amazing. Other games where like you fall behind a little bit, I've seen Clockworks do almost next to nothing. So I feel like this is a hero that doesn't often get a lot done.
Yeah, he has a couple of weaknesses, but the best thing about him is that he doesn't really need any help in the offlane. And most offlaners are almost too weak to not get any support. There's only a couple that can really go on their own, and those are, first off, a hero like Clockwork or like other heroes that can just go to the jungle. Being able to pull your lane back with like a cog block or something is like super useful. So that's one of the reasons he's getting picked so much.
We mentioned the Bane combo. It looks like a Bane Lina, maybe the puppy Kuro duo here. Kuro really likes his support Lina.
Yeah, it's good. He plays it really well too. Kuro always finds a lot of farm on this hero. He gets the early Yules and then maybe an axe or a blink dagger or something.
Yep. So Secret likely just looking for one last core here. You mentioned Magnus could be an off lane if they want to pick something like a Slark or another core hero. As for Alliance, looking for that Loda hero as far as the safe lane goes. They haven't really got any clear Wisp partner either just yet, so is that something where Alliance are going to be looking to get some kind of hero that can benefit a lot from the Tether overcharge, or are they just happy to use the Wisp for the stacks and other reasons?
No, they're going to Tether up a carry here. It's going to be a melee carry as well. They banned out the Axe to ensure the laning phase. I think it's going to be probably PA or Juggernaut. Or, oh, what else is on the hero list? Lotus Sven? No, Alliance used to love Wisp Sven, but Sven's kind of bad in this meta right now.
Loda does like the hero. You're against a Troll Magus Bristleback. There we go.
Okay. So, pretty early game centric, but we'll see. If Bristleback with six slots is a very terrifying thing if it's running right at you.
Well, early game centric, but yeah, I've seen Bristlebacks in the late game do a lot of damage and turn into those kind of big, scary late game carries as well.
He can also turn his back and reduce a lot of trolls' damage as well, which is nice.
Just being able to do damage without having to actually fight head on against the troll just because of the quills, so it does make his life a bit easier if he's trying to kite around a troll. 5 seconds
remaining. Yep, that's definitely.
So Secret's last pick here. What are we thinking? What do they need?
Either a Zai hero or an S4 hero. I'm not sure. I would like for them to have an easier way to kill this Bristleback. Right now they have a lot of... Focus Fire is pretty good, but they don't have a way to make him face him.
It looks like to me an S4 Windranger mid.
Yeah. In the past they've done Axe and Windranger together, and then they just call the Bristleback and have the Bristleback face the Windranger, and then Windranger just melts him down with the Focus Fire. But they don't have that this game, so it's going to be a little bit more difficult.
Yeah. That's why the axe ban really kind of led into that Bristle back pick pretty well. I guess they could have ran the axe as the offlane and get Magnus in the mid lane, so helping secure Lotus mid game, well, at least his game in general here, not having to deal with an axe. So Team Secret,
They could go aggro tri-lane as well
for Team Secret
Alliance. Either really.
Is that? I mean, I feel like there's not many teams you're seeing the aggro tri-lanes out of. Maybe like a 2-1-2 setup, but not so much the aggro tri-lanes here. I guess if you've got a strong safe lane solo, you can make it work. Which, I mean, you've definitely got for Alliance with the potential, like you could put like a Queen of Pain or someone in the safe lane, but.
Looks like they're just gonna do traditional lanes. Yep. Or maybe. Oh, Bristle could go mid as well.
Bristle, like a Wisp Bristleback, for sure. It looks like Pycat is headed down bottom. He hasn't gone for the two pull Tengos build, so.
Yeah, that looks like a safe lane build to me.
The Wisping around the mid lane, it just kind of sets up the stacks a lot nicer here. So he does. If you're safe lane supporting a Bristleback, you're not really able to stack as efficiently as otherwise you can from the mid lane.
That's true.
But we'll see how things unravel.
It's not a bad idea.
What is up with Arteezy's name, Tinky Winky?
That's a Teletubby thing.
Oh yeah, it is a Teletubby thing. I guess it suits him. I feel like Tinky Winky was before his generation. Teletubby still even on air? Didn't one of them like get? Didn't they run into like legal problems with one of their Teletubbies?
I'm not up to date on my Teletubbies meta, unfortunately.
Okay, that's not what I bring you on for. Don't worry. Well.
Yeah.
We'll see the teams and the lanes unravel here. On Team Alliance, on the Radiant side, we've got Nico in the offlane Clockwork. It looks like Loader going to be on the Bristleback, potentially in the mid lane with Aki on the Wisp. Get that Loader-Aki bromance going. Majka going to be on the Trium Protector, and Pycat going on the what looks to be safe lane solo Queen of Pain. On the Dire side, Team Secret going to have Zai on the Magnus. We'll have Puppy on the Bane, Tinky Winky or Arteezy on the Troll Warlord, S4 Windranger, and Kuroki playing the support Lina here for Team Secret. Interesting, Zai's even gone for what looks to be a mid build here. It looks like he's trying to like reveal himself and like play some mind games and bait Alliance into thinking he's mid.
Yeah, maybe. I think that's just kind of a cheeky thing that Zai would do.
Just show himself. Like, he's hoping that he gets scouted out here. Like, no one's actually moved forward in the mid lane and seen him yet, but maybe just walk even further down the river and try and bait him out even more.
Yeah, he probably will.
It could affect how Alliance lanes things. If they see the Magnus bid, they're more likely to send the Queen of Pain there, I guess, do you think? Or is it... I mean, it probably doesn't really affect things for Alliance.
Yeah, I mean, Windranger can pretty much go up against Quap 1v1, or she can go up against the Bristle Wisp 1v2. Pretty fine. I don't see them putting Magnus mid, but they could run an aggro tri-lane with the... Like, they could just throw Windranger in the offlane and then kind of roam the Bane Lina. And they could even like challenge the safe lane with that combination.
All right. Well, no spoilers for that. We don't want that. Are you a Game of Thrones watcher? Are you counting down the days?
I'm not counting down the days, but yeah, I have watched it.
Okay. That's probably a similar boat that I'm in. I'm not like jumping out of my seat to start watching it, but I'm excited. That ain't even true. Come on, Zai. Twitch chat are not going to be pleased with Zai at this point. What if there are viewers out there who hadn't seen it? I have friends who have like just started to watch season one who watched Dota who may have just had their viewing experience ruined.
You ever just get a PM on Twitch like, hey, please unban me from your channel, and then you just copy paste all the Game of Thrones spoilers and then send it back to them?
Oh, no. I'm going to be honest. No, I have not.
You've never done that before. That's just me then.
Should I start doing that? What else can I spoil? What are the other big... I guess Game of Thrones is the big kind of show these days to spoil. Is that what you do to people who ask to be on band?
I've never done that before, but I've heard...
It sounds like a PPD thing.
No. I have other bad influences in my life that tell me the terrible things that they do.
And I feel like there's a few of those in the NA Dota scene, but... Well,
I'm no name-namer.
Don't worry, I'm not asking for names. I'm not going to have you throw people under the bus here just yet, but that sounds cruel. That sounds really cruel. At the same time, they'll probably, you know, we get people PMing us all the time, like, oh, I did nothing, I don't know why I was banned, I hadn't been in your Twitch chat for like a year, and then our mods will like, I'll be like, oh, do I ban this guy? And our mods will be like, that guy was in there a week ago, like, posting, like, swastikas and stuff, and I'm just like, okay, good to know. So I'll just let you guys handle this.
Yep.
People are Very deceptive.
So are you excited for the last NA qualifier spot for Summit tonight?
I'm pretty excited. I think.
Are you casting?
I'm not casting. I'm casting. I'm on the Europe schedule. I think Cottle guy's casting, maybe with Zayori. I'm
not sure.
But do you think Not Today will take that, or is that going to be?
I think so.
I mean, I still don't know who's playing for Complexity. So, it's
they have. Yeah, they have some roster issues, but I think they have their five right now, at least for okay. this qualifier.
Yeah, yeah, they've been playing with Zizou, the Romanian yeah. guy. That was such. They just pick up like the most random players. It's weird.
It's hard to find people that, especially in the NA, it's really hard to find people that are committed to something like this because everyone in NA is like going to work or school and they can't play during the day and
a lot of
full time. It's really hard to do.
A lot of the tournaments and qualifiers, you have to be able to play during the day to some extent, especially if you're on like the West Coast. The matches are even earlier, so
exactly.
Okay. Well. We'll see. We'll see how they do later on. That's going to be Complexity versus Not Today. So the other team. Are you excited for the Summit 3 now that you've qualified? You've survived the grueling NA qualifiers.
Yep. It was best of three was intense, but everything else easy peasy.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. It'll be fun. I'm looking forward to it.
Summit 3, man. Hype.
All right, now Star Ladder, not so high. We've got Arteezy still looking to reconnect as Troll Warlord is not in the game. That's what you get for pick and troll. I don't know. Is this Troll Hero, like, to you, one of the heroes that most needs to be kind of tweaked in the upcoming patches, or are there other heroes you have your eye on that need to be kind of...
I mean, there's a lot of heroes that need some changes, but that's the same with every patch. It's always everyone always complains about certain heroes, and other heroes look weak, and other heroes look strong. But people will figure it out. Troll, though, seems to be, like, people aren't figuring him out, though, which I think is the problem. Like, Juggernaut was super at, like, DAC and for a little bit after, but he's been picked less and less since because people are figuring out how to play against him. Troll, though, it's, like, Troll and Sniper, they're still just, like, top tier just because they're insane. Like, it's actually a viable strategy for you to sit in your base when you're losing massively with the Sniper, and you just sit in your base as long as you can, and you still have a chance to win. Yeah. I've seen, like, there was a game earlier today, the last game you casted, that was like that.
Yes.
The
game one at Polar Empire, yeah.
They were down so much, they almost won the game. And, yeah, they just sit in their base with Sniper or Dusa, and you just wait.
And they didn't even have, like, I mean, it was just Sniper, like, they didn't have any other big late gamers. Like, they somehow got center suddenly back in the game. DK Phobos was, like, support mode as a core Zeus and somehow finds items just by sitting in his base waiting. Yeah. So
crazy, like, if you can't I mean, no carrier can, like, trade with Sniper or Troll because they just Troll will bash lock you, Sniper will reduce your attack speed so you can't even hit him. It's just
not fun to push into.
It's tough to play against.
People need
which is fine, but
yeah, it's always going to be that challenge of, like, how do you actually break high ground? It used to be, like, when you had around the Death Prophet and Shadow Shaman era, not an issue. But now that's not viable.
Gold. They reduce tower gold, and they you know, make glyph timers for every single tier one. And then, you know, tower, like, pushing towers is, like, bad for you because you take you take bad fights, I guess. It just... There's a lot of things going on. I don't want to really get into all of it, but yeah.
I mean, it's like you say, every time you figure out a patch, there's always a few heroes which become problem heroes and a few playstyles which become, like, just annoying. In this case, it's like the high ground sieging. In the past patches, it was the, like, let's 5-man all your towers in 15 minutes and win the game. So
yeah,
it seems there's always something. I still, like, remember, like, as much, like, when I see people, like, saying, oh, the troll jugging all my pub games, I'm like, man, I'd take this over at least the old Tinkers and stuff. I hated playing pub games against Tinkers.
Tinker was tough. I hate playing pub games against Broodmother and Troll.
Yeah.
Right now, but that's...
Is Brood a big thing? Brood seems like, at least as far as competitive games go, I think Brood's in a pretty good place.
I think she's in an okay place.
But yeah. It's one of those annoying heroes because it changes. It's like has that techies effect, not to the point of ridiculousness of techies, but you have to change, like, your entire playstyle and strategy as soon as that Brood comes out.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, it is a game-altering hero. Well, I hope we see Zaiteki's next game. They should have done it. They should have done S4 Magnus and then big Zaiteki's.
Did you see that Teki's game? How, I mean, it wasn't as bad as the DAC. I mean, I guess they won the DAC one, but I don't know.
No, actually, I didn't see it, but I saw it got picked.
It was cool. Low impact. But they actually lost that game, unlike the DAC one.
But you're connecting.
All right, we're getting there. Tinky Winky's back in the game. Hopefully everything runs smoothly now. Good thing you have a day off from your tough qualifier schedule to cast some Dota, and here you are, plagued by pauses.
Ah, you know, it's fine. I'd be watching the games anyways, just suffering through pauses. But, you know, we do have a day off. It's kind of nice. Everyone's traveling to Boston, excluding me and Sumail, for our boot camp.
Yep. Okay. So you'll just boot camp with them remotely then?
I mean, I live on the East Coast, or I live in the Midwest, but, you know, I can play on Luxembourg without a problem. Our issue is that no European teams will play us on East, so.
Okay, so the boot camp's it's more about being able to play on Europe rather than, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
That makes more sense. I wouldn't want to have to sleep in the same room as AUI and Universe. I don't want to know what goes on between those two in a bootcamp setting.
They don't room together. Like,
okay, so it's all a farce, basically, is what you're saying. Okay, who rooms with who? What's the arrangement?
You know, we've only been to like two lands together. I roomed with AUI for both of them, and then I think Universe roomed with Jamel.
Okay, know,
father son. And then Fear and Charlie.
Yeah. Okay. Get the two old men together.
Charlie makes like a lot of weird like throat noises. He like coughs up like phlegm and like gargles and stuff. And like so nobody ever wants to room with him.
Okay.
So
okay.
It's like
Fear just has to take one for the team there.
Yeah.
All right. Well, looks like at least Alliance is ready. I'm not sure what's the go with Secret. Hopefully nothing too bad. Oh, he's gone again. Tinky Winky.
GG.
GG indeed. Wrap it up. Yeah. Online Dota 2 in a nutshell. Game is paused.
This is the second group phase of the Star Ladder Season 12 qualifiers.
It sounds like having these stage twos. Like I know we had it with the summit too, where we have like a phase one, phase two. It sounds like there's more qualifiers, like qualifiers within qualifiers, but it is less matches and like less games. So it has been kind of condensed down a bit. But
isn't it the same exact thing?
As far
like
they played
against the first part of the qualifier, they were in a group of four where they played everyone in a best of three, and then in this one they're doing the same exact thing.
Yeah, they cut it down to like from four groups to two groups.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, just as opposed to last season where it's like 16 teams, big round robin, and nobody really knows what's going on in any one game. It's like, okay, we have a best of one here. We don't really know if we need to win this or not. Let's just win as many as we can.
Yeah. That's kind of what Star Ladder's been, though, since the beginning.
Yeah.
Which was kind of like its own unique thing.
Well, times are changing. Looks like Alliance going to lose a player as well on their side. 4v4, it's all fair now. You know what I think at least unranked pub games need is the swap player option that you had in Dota 1. So if it gets down to like a 5v3, you can just like swap a player over and continue 4v4.
What an awful mechanic. That was the worst, man. You'd have carries who were like super farmed and they're like, I don't want this game to end. And they just switch teams and start killing everyone on your team.
I mean, I think everyone had to agree with it. Was everyone on both? I think everyone on both teams had to agree to it. So I guess you could reject it.
I don't know. I remember some awful things happening to me, and I'd like to think my team didn't accept that it was going to happen.
Okay, well.
Maybe it was like you needed like half the people in there, and then like your carry would like want to swap, and then their entire team would want to swap or something.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how it works. It was a long time ago.
That was a long time ago.
Super pubby back then.
And that was how Super Puppy sums up Dota 1 in its beginnings, but there were some fun mechanics. I miss the old Drow ulti. I feel like every time I see a Drow, like I miss that old, like the 10% chance to instantly kill a creeper in neutral. And just from auto-attacking. That was like my favorite spell for some stupid reason. Now you have this stupid marksmanship thing, which just gives agility. I don't know. Well, I don't know if Seeker are going to be finding a stand-in or what here.
I'm in. I'm the sickest troll warlord there is.
you're ready to
I'm
go.
I'm playing in Starladder. Let's go.
I think, yeah, that's to say, I think you're allowed to stand in if you want
to. Let's get the fossil old man fear in here.
he's an actual troll player.
Today. He's traveling today.
Okay, so you may have to play then.
Could get Sumel. All
right, if he's available, ring him up. Let Secret know.
I'd have to call his house and talk to his mother. I'm not sure I want to do that.
Have you had to do that before? That sounds...
No, that's a Charlie job.
Yeah.
Is Sumail there?
Does he call him Sumail to Sumail's mom?
Yeah, I think so. That's
okay.
His name.
Okay, that was my follow-up question. I was like, I didn't realize Sumail was his actual name, not just his in-game name. Okay. All right, that makes sense then. That makes more sense. I'm out of the loop here.
Come on, dude. And I told him, man.
Making me feel bad. Don't know my players, my scene.
That's okay. You're just a caster.
Yeah, I'm just a caster. Look, ask me about the Oz Dota scene. I'll tell you all you need to know.
Tell me anything. Do I need to know anything?
No, you don't exactly. there's not much to know about the Oz Dota scene here.
So who's our Australian hope for TI5?
I guess CSW, but they've only got like one Australian player on the team anymore. But
Australian pride.
That's all you need. It's like when Slicks went to Korea. I was like, all right, this is my new team. MVP Hot 6 with Slicks. Do you associate
New Zealand with your Aussie scene as well, or not?
I mean, if there's a good New Zealand player, absolutely. They quickly become an Australian player. It's like Canada, man. Like, it's like if there's a Canadian player who becomes a big star, I'm sure like the NA Dota scene would still embrace them. I mean, I guess NA Dota isn't just the US anyways.
America was like absolving Alliance during TI3. Like, Alliance would make a great play and everyone would just be shouting USA in the chat. That was my favorite.
Oh, I mean, that's Na'Vi as well. I feel like anywhere Na'Vi go, at least during their prime, it was like they would just be fan favorites. Even recently, in Malaysia, dude. When Na'Vi were playing against Invasion, who's a Malaysian team, there were more people cheering for Na'Vi than Invasion. I'm just like, are you kidding me? Like, this is a Malaysian team playing in Malaysia, and man, something about that guy Dendi, just people love him.
Yep.
It's crazy. Well, hopefully the craziness of this game one is gonna happen soon. He's back in the game. We got Tinky Winky.
Any second now.
All right, Secret's ready. All right, that's good news.
The people with the craziest fans, though, are China for burning, though.
Yeah, the way it was described to me is that, like, even people who don't play Dota or know anything about gaming, like, still if they hear the name Burning, will be like, oh, that's that guy who's really famous. Yeah.
So. Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Did you guys have a lot of fans in China? Was that, like, kind of crazy for you guys as well?
Yeah, there's a lot of people. The Chinese girls love Sumail. They couldn't get enough of him.
I can just imagine Sumail, awkward 15-year-old, unsure how to deal with that situation.
He usually just ran away.
I think me at 15 would have done the same, so I can just smile and kind of relate to that one. So here we go, horn gonna blow. We've introduced our teams, but we'll run over our lamps again. Looks like Loda on the Bristleback, Aki on the Wisp, those two headed towards mid lane. Majka gonna be on your safe lane, support Treant for Pycat's Queen of Pain. In the off lane, Nico on the Clockwork. Secret gonna be running the Kuroki Lina up top supporting your TZ Troll Warlord. We're gonna have S4 going mid on the Windranger, Puppy on the Bane, and then finally Magnus. In the offlane for Zai, still sticking with this two pull Tengu's build, looked like he does want to rush a bottle even in the offlane.
Do you know how to pronounce Zai's name?
Nope. Do you?
Nope.
I know how to pronounce Zai. I don't know what the player's deal is getting these Tinky Winky and this name, which I'm looking at. I don't know how to say it. Stick with Zai. That's the best I've got. So Enfeeble early on a Bristleback. This is Lotus not happy. He's knocked me out to get too much farm. This is what I saw Misery do with his Bane. Get Enfeeble level 1 and just like win the mid lane for your mid lane player using this.
I think you can last hit with Quills though. Like you auto attack and Quill at the same time. It's almost like an auto attack anyways.
Yeah.
Don't think it's that big of a deal for him.
So Puppy just going to get some stacks going and probably come back and use a few more. Yeah, so far Loda doing okay. Missing a cool last hit there, but it's kind of like a normal last hit, but it's not going to be perfect.
Yeah, he'll get some stacks in the jungle though. He'll be fine. Bristleback's a comeback hero.
Yeah, And well, we're seeing those stacks already start to happen. That's your power of your Wisp here. Your loader may not get the farm he wants in the mid lane, but he'll have the stacks to work around. So it looks like trailing for Secret. Bane's done his job in the mid lane and going to make his way top lane. Kuro and Puppy even getting to farm up this big Hellbear camp, so Kuro just using his kind of Light Strike Array level 1 to make sure they get this, kite it back and forth, and Niqua just looks to leech some XP.
Something you'll see supports do a lot is they'll pull the first wave and then they'll connect the pull, and then they usually end up having to right click down the hard camp because they want it to spawn again in 2 minutes, so they can do the same thing over.
It's a nice play. Also, they zone Niqua out so he doesn't leech the XP for the Hellbear, so Puppy gets level 2.
Yeah, and now he has to sleep, so he can combo it up with Kuro.
And so the most part, looks like we'll just see Puppy focus around getting the stacks going, using the pulls, and Kuro, similar story, zoning out Niqua kind of in between here. He has hit level 2 in the offlane. As for Zai, still level 1, has got his bottle up. We'll find the bounty rune. That, where's the rune control from either team there? They got the top rune, but bottom one's still waiting around, and Zai will come in. And with this pull camp here, likely could find his level 2 off of this. But Pyke gonna blink in. Zai doesn't have a skewer. This is first blood.
Zai's... see what he tried to do there? He tried to... Oh, what are you doing? Kill him.
He tried to go at level 2 with the shockwave on the neutrals. Oh, he's got it! Tengo? That was almost survived with that Tengo regen. Yeah. Top lane, meanwhile, Niqua in some trouble. There's gonna be a stun from Kuro. He does get inside the cogs, and there's a Dragon Slayer, but doesn't look like he's gonna want to throw... Oh, it doesn't have mana anymore after the cog hit.
That was kind of cool, though. Like, Zai tried to... He used his bounty rune in his bottle, and then he threw a shockwave at the neutrals, and he tried to get his level 2 from that. But he ended up not getting it until he walked into the lane and got it there.
Did come very close to surviving. Pycat, though, 2 points in the Shadow Strike, is starting to bully Zai out of this lane. Oh my god, this right-click harass, and Zai...
Well, you got treads off that, too. Oof.
That's painful stuff. Zai does get the creep wave to his tower. He needs to chew through this bottle as soon as that Shadow Strike wears off, because otherwise, you're going to see a Blink Shadow Strike and probably a death onto him. Low detonate. He's getting aggressive on S4, even leveling up the goo at level 4, and S4 in some trouble here. Pops a Windrun. Nice Shackle Shot onto 2. Power Shot to follow. But S4 just needs one more kill to get the kill. Loader going to turn around. Nope, with the bottle regen. He's not going to get it, and Bane gets one. Possibly a second Puppy with a Nightmare. Power Shot. S4 says, I'll take that kill, Puppy. And Puppy turned that one around, and S4 says, I'm just going to steal your kill.
Yeah, nice rotation by Puppy there. A little bit of an overextension, though. Like, you can kind of do that with Bristle, but you know, Windrunner, she has the Windrun, so you gotta be careful for that.
That's a big couple of kills to be getting in that mid lane, and also just time where you're not maybe getting some additional stacks. You get Windranger, a big chunk of gold.
Bell and Crookie here, I think.
Yeah. And you're quite gonna find him with the boots there. Bottom lane was Zai almost going down to the Queen of Pain, but... will be another kill going the Alliance way. That's a solo kill for a Clockwork. He wasn't getting much XP or farm in that offlane, so this will help him out quite a lot as far as his game goes.
That's big. I think he just walked up to him, or maybe Croaky's trying to come uphill.
Using that with the help of that Radiant Ward, maybe finding a Leech Seed up top. They want to go in on Arteezy. Not going to be an easy kill, especially with the Blind Chance from the Whirling Axes. They're still chasing with Battery Assault, but not particularly close to getting this kill. S4 goes in. Avoids the cogs there, but not going to get this kill right away. Still has a haste rune, still looking to chase. The bottle regen coming in from Ake. There's also some overcharge, and it looks like S4 not going to find any counter kills, but did force out the TP Alliance, but they didn't even come close to killing Arteezy. This troll hero.
That's such a hard kill to take. Like, the Bree's going to get Whirling Axe, and he's not going to be able to connect on any of his auto attacks. But they did force a rotation, and they forced all the regen out of roll, so maybe when Clock gets a couple more levels, he might be able to solo kill him.
Pycat at bottom, maybe in some trouble here. Puppy's rotated in, there's a Nightmare into a Light Strike Array. This is looking bad for Pycat. Nice wall time gank. Shockwave, no skewer, but they're not going to need it. Down goes your Queen of Pain. Successful smoke from Secret. Especially during the night, very, very potent top lane. Meanwhile, Tinky Winky's been left alone. He's saying, where's my buddies? Where's Lala? Arteezy. Gonna be trying to hide away in some trees here, but there's no TP support, and he goes down. So both teams losing their safe lane farmer.
Yeah, I hope Pokemon had cooldown on tree armor, because I think that could have saved Qualp the bottom lane. But I'm not sure. He may have been more focused on getting that troll kill top, which is probably a bigger kill, I think.
Radiant's bottom tower. Not as bad as one of the... There was a game earlier today where a sniper could have been kept alive and instead the living armor was used on the tower. I don't know if you saw that in the Polar Empire series.
I wasn't watching it that closely, but yeah, that'll happen. A lot of times when you're playing Treant and you click on the mini-map, a lot of people, players will do that to just click the hero, and then sometimes it can... Usually it'll prioritize the heroes if it's like closer to them, but sometimes you know you might accidentally click too close to the tower.
Alright, well, things kind of stabilize here. 3 kills apiece, nothing really separating the two teams in terms of farm. And we'll see both teams at least getting their kind of core levels here. Niqua approaching level 5, so he's going to be in a pretty good place as far as his offlane goes. Zai, similar story, getting at least some XP out of this lane, but there is some kill threat coming out of Pycat's Queen of Pain. Sonic Wave is available, blinks in with a Shadow Strike. Pycat, he raised his arms for the ulti, but held onto it when the skewer came out.
Yep, and this is actually a really good game for Clockwork to get a lot done. Windranger, if she doesn't get a super early 4-staff, they don't really have... I mean,
oh, Pycat. Oh dear, he blinked in looking for Zai, and this is going to set up everything here. They're going to chain stun him down, but he gets the kill. There's your Living Armor. Queen of Pain will bring down one with him. The Living Armor coming to at least delay his death and allow him to get the Sonic Wave kill.
Yeah, those two kills are really big for Team Secret. They're getting a lot of levels on their supports now.
Yeah. Wow, Puppy almost level 6 already. That is very potent stuff. Magicka's coming to the jungle and will scout out TZ. TZ ping, though. I think he maybe realized that some of his XP was being leeched and something's going on here. As Magnus is actually going to TP top and make his way towards the safe lane.
Yep. And Bucky-Matt's trying to do a thing where you kind of walk around with Treant. It's pretty tough, though, when you don't have any mana items yet. Also, his Invis is only level 1, so it only lasts for 15 seconds.
Yeah, he's pinging out that TZ. He's got a pretty big stack here that he wants to try and contest. He can lead with the Leech Seed. Here comes your Clockwork. Hookshot in. Hits perfectly. Arteezy trapped in the cogs. Can try and break his way through, but doesn't look like it's going to happen. Loader leads the way, and it's actually the Wisp getting the kill, and now they can take this little neutral stack. This is a triple stack, and double Centaurs and Alpha Wolves. Pretty damn nice for Alliance.
Yep, Treant's level 5 now, too. He's getting closer and closer to coming online. I like to think right around level 8, Treant's like the strongest he'll be. He has 4 points in Living Armor and then 2 points in Nature's Guise, and you can kind of just like walk around the entire map. Generally, you have Mana Boots at that point, too. I'm not sure if Bucking Mad goes Mana Boots, though. Does he rush Ags on tree? Have you seen?
I only know FNG does that, but apart from him, I don't know anyone else who does that. I think... I mean, I can only speculate. I don't know for sure.
Yeah.
Well, you normally go the Arcane Boots, right?
Yeah, I've been playing around with Ags a little bit, but I'm still a fan of Arcane Boots, I think.
Oh, here's the Nature's Guise player, Pycat, getting right in close here. They see Puppy as well. Puppy goes with a grip. Pycat could open up off of this. Gets a Shadow Strike as well as the Scream. Magicka gonna go down, but... The stun's still coming out, gonna miss Pycat, and with the Wisp support here. Oh, it's a Shackle! That tree! Coming out of nowhere! Puppy's still in trouble. The second Scream gonna finish him off. An S4, very low on HP. Aki, kept alive for now. The blink in. Pycat has another Scream, needs to hit on S4. Won't be able to do so right away. The Shackle gonna miss, and Zai's got an RP, though. Looking for that onto Pycat, maybe in a skewer back. Kuro, Lightstrike Array is there. RP gonna be used. Pycat being healed up by the Overcharge as well as the Wisp on the higher ground. Sonic Wave goes through, gets S4. Pycat's alive. The Scream comes out. It's a double kill for Pycat. He wants more. He wants Zai, and Zai out of mana, running out of HP. Pycat, unfortunately, only has a blink and will be forced back by a TP coming in from Puppy, but that is a big team fight for Team Alliance.
It is so hard to kill cores when you have a Wisp tethered as well as tree armor. It's... Yeah, we actually did a combo like that. It's the Summit 1 with our... If you remember, we had PA, Treant, and Wisp.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The crits.
That was a great game. It's like impossible to kill them.
Alright. Well, that's a big team fight for Alliance. Pycat somehow just staying alive throughout it all, and... Loader was just mid lane the whole time. He pushed down the tier 1 tower, got some more additional gold and map control for his team, and it looks like they're trying to make another move towards Arteezy on this troll warlord, although a bit low on mana here. They're going to relocate in. They want to go on this with the Leech Seed. TP support coming in. That's going to be your Kuro Lina, but can he get here in time? Arteezy getting low. The Quill's kind of actually out of mana. Loader does not have the mana to go for this one, and they're going to lose one, possibly a second. Alliance getting maybe too aggressive. They lose the second, and Loader kind of stranded here, but does have the Vanguard. Looks like he'll be okay, but that did not work.
Yep, little too overambitious, I think. Loader was actually really low on mana.
Yeah, that was the biggest problem there. Like, he got a few goos off, and then suddenly it's like, I can't even keep stacking quills, so Even I think if he had a bit more money, it would still look kind of ambitious from Alliance.
It's very forced.
And they're just trying to keep up the aggression, which is smart. They have a pretty big early game advantage, I think. They want to keep up the aggression, but that was just, unfortunately, went poorly.
Well, Aki as well as Lota going back in the top lane. It's going to be a shackle onto Aki. He's going to be healed up by the Living Armor. Keeps him alive a little bit longer. Meanwhile, Kuro chased down by Lota. He will go down. Can Lota get out of this one? Low mana on your troll. S4 coming around the side looking for a shackle shot. Won't find it. Quill Sprays is there and Zygo skewering forward, but it looks like Lota will be okay.
That's surprising. I was really surprised S4 didn't hit that shackle shot. I just assumed S4 was gonna land it.
It's S4. I was looking around. I'm like, if this is me, what am I shackling him to? I don't see anything, but S4 will find something. I'll get a grip kill on mid lane Treant Protector, but
yeah. I'm not saying he had an opportunity to do it. I just naturally when I see S4 wind and they're throwing a shackle, I just think it's gonna land.
Yeah, he knows there's like some tree which it's like the one at bottom lane in that random tree that just is near the river that he happened to hit. S4 could be in some trouble here. There's a Sonic Wave Scream and even the Rocket Flare gonna help things out. Pycat thought about holding onto the ulti, didn't need to, or did have to use it in the end, and gets a kill, a solo kill on your Windranger.
Yeah, so Secret's blocking camps with their wards instead of looking for a vision, unlike the runes. So that's the map is kind of dark for Secret for the most part.
And Queen of Pain just like walked into the Roshan pit and was using it to hide, so it gets a few more wards up now, so we'll see what they can do with this. But Alliance are grouping up near the top lane, looking to push down a tier 1 tower here, and Nikwa heading up there as well. So this will be 4-man rotation. Pykit can theoretically TP as up there as well if they're worried about a fight breaking out, but it seems Secret looking to let this one go and not defend it. Actually, it's going to be a hookshot in the neutrals, misses Arteezy. Nikwa fishing, but doesn't find anything. Aggressive wards being planted now in this dire jungle to try and assist some of these kills.
Roshan time?
Possibly Pycat blinks forward to bottom lane. S4 relocate as well. This is looking bad for your Windranger. Shackle will land this time around. Lota still chasing him with the spirits. That's a nice kill coming out for Ake. Zai in some trouble. Has a skewer maybe to help cover his retreat. Good combo. The two hero stun from Kuro blows up your Wisp, and Lota can't chase on his own. Loses that tether movement speed and decides to back off.
Really good trade for Alliance. Same situation as Team Secret. They're using their wards for jungle vision of their opponents rather than map vision, I guess. So they just don't see like anything that's happening in the rivers.
I don't see this, and that's going to be, well, a Secret wraparound into this jungle. Looks like they want to steal the stack, although an aggressive ward will also scout out Lota in this mid lane. Zai gonna take most of what's this triple stack down here. Nice chunk of gold to work towards his Blink Dagger, which he will have the money for now. Picks it up and he's in a pretty good spot here. Only the 1 point in skewer. He wants to max his empower as early as possible.
Clockwork.
Meanwhile, on the river here, it's going to be S4 in some trouble. The DD rune up top, but he's being body blocked, and that wind run didn't really save his life there, as it looks like Lota are going to be able to bring him down with the quills.
Ugh, I hate playing as Wisp Bristleback.
It's working out well for Alliance so far.
Yeah, it's so strong. Like, he's such a monster with the tether.
Top lane, hookshot catches Arteezy. Sonic Wave and everything. They'll blow up your Troll Warlord. Alliance, as you said, keeping up the aggression, using this early game lead, and using just the power of this Wisp Bristleback and just the early game lineup with Clockwork, Queen of Pain, to get a lot done here in the early game. Nikwa's got a 4-star all of a sudden. This is looking pretty nice for Team Alliance. They'll take towers and objectives as well.
Yep, they're doing really well. They're having a great early game. They're getting kills where they need kills to be had, and Secret probably needs to, it's tough because we kind of have the omniscient view of like knowing where all the wards are, but right now Alliance is just playing in Secret's jungle, and if Secret can like kind of figure this out, they can just either go for the bottom tower or just play in their jungle or stick troll on Ancients or even do Roshan.
In kind of typical Secret fashion, they have got a lot of farm on their supports. It's something they seem to do more than a lot of teams. Like, Run, Kuro's got the second most farm on his team. Even Puppy with 2.5k net worth has got a Tranquil Soaring already, so it's not like as the gold difference is not as big as like the top core heroes suggest, because Secret is kind of this much greater farm distribution across their lineup.
There you go, though. We have Empower on Troll, and he's gonna clear some Ancients.
This will make up for a lot of the gold differential between Troll and the Bristle.
Yeah, it's big.
So, elsewhere for Alliance, it looks like, I mean, you mentioned the Arcane Boots on Trier. At this point, Magicka is just hoping to finish those sometime soon, I guess. Not getting much farm on your Trier and Protector.
Definitely is not.
So, Blink Dagger on your Magnus. Could be looking to use this to start finding some pickoffs. Blinks forward, RP. It's a solo RP onto Ake. They'll grip it and everything. That's some serious hate.
Yeah, so instantly Magicka pings the bottom tower. He says, hey, we're going to go take this fight. No RP, no Fiend's Grip. It's time to go.
Yeah. Looks like Loda, though, still at the mid lane. So still just three heroes down there. If Secret want to try and at least defend, use that power shot spam, the Dragon Slave. But it seems Secret have other ideas, which is just to farm there and let this bottom tier 1 tower go if Alliance are going to commit for it. Wisp can just TP mid on respawn and offer that threat of a relocate should Secret try and defend against these three heroes. And yeah, Wisp will go mid, so effectively this could quickly become five heroes at bottom lane if Secret aren't careful.
No, they're just going to back off though. They know that they don't have their ults. They can't really, they don't want necessarily to fight right now.
So Pycat, looks like an ulti ult pickup for him, maybe going straight into a Scythe of Vice. Not your standard Queen of Pain build. You mentioned the Yules that Sumail likes, or S4 almost exclusively goes for the Orchid Rush. This is something completely different, the Hex Rush.
Yeah, Hex offers a couple different things. It makes them a lot tankier.
They also can, they can stop Windrunner from just, like, running away. Like, Orchid, their heroes will just walk away, I guess. I don't know.
Especially if a 4 staff's up, but 4 staff, S4 is actually not very farmed. He's having a rough game.
He's not.
I kind of expect, like, this is the time where you'd have a 4 staff, but not the case. Relocate mid. Oh, boy. That range. Puppy's still going to go down, I think. There we go, the scream. He gets off a brain sap and makes it a lot more difficult than it should have been.
Yeah, casting all the spells at least.
Force out an overgrowth and a relocate. They leave the Roshan pit for now. Looks like they want to defend and push out these lanes and make the most out of the map before they take Roshan. But for now, it's going to be pushing out farm in the top lane. They've got bottom lane issues as well. Arteezy's starting to accumulate some farm himself with the Yasha. We'll see where he looks to go after this. If he gets the straight BKB or completes maybe a Sanjin Yasha first.
Ancient stacks. This is quickly becoming a problem for Alliance.
They've got a lot of farm out of this. Well, and Secret's...
I like Treant against Secret's kind of playstyle. Like, whenever you see Secret playing, they're always, like, ratting and, like, split-pushing. But if you have Treant to, like, armor up your towers and, like, kind of, like, walk around invis all the time, they can kind of find them before it actually happens and keep their towers alive, which is really important.
There's been a number of times where Magicka has just been in a position with the Nature's guys to scout out, like, a Secret hero or two who are alone and set up these kills. He's only gone for 1 point in the invis, which is a bit surprising, not having...
I was surprised by that, too.
Yeah.
See, the smoke gank from... or smoke to Roshan or something is happening here.
Well, Nico can just scout him out, the rocket flare and everything. He gets caught by the grip, doesn't get a chance to hook or force stuff out of there, but...
thought maybe he would buy back if there's going to be a Rosh fight.
Looks like they have the good Radiant Vision. They see the Ancients now, at least. The Sentry Ward goes down, and Puppy will immediately deward it, though. So this does give Secret a bit of an edge around this. Well, there's still one more Radiant Ward, which has a Sentry on it below the Rosh pit. But looks like at least Alliance know that Secret aren't going to the Roshan pit right away off of that. So they'll hold the Clockwork buyback, and things kind of settle down here. Just a 3,000 gold lead for Alliance, and experience lead going the way of Team Secret. Doesn't really feel like either team has a big advantage right now. Secret have that gold deficit mostly because they've yet to be able to push down a single tower.
No, it's very, very even. It's all going to depend on the ultimates of Team Secret and whether or not Alliance can survive through them. They have RP, Laguna, Fiend's Grip, and then I guess just Trolls right clicks. But I would really look for Kuroki and Zai to make the big plays here, and then Puppy to find a good Fiend's Grip target.
Let's see what Pycat can do as well with this Scythe of Vice. He's going to be one of those... he has to be a playmaker. He's the main kind of initiator or potential counter. If Magnus blinks in, if you can catch him with a Hex before he RPs or skewers, kind of make that S4 play we saw that he likes to do with his Orchid, where he catches the blink initiator before they can use their stun or whatever it may be. But it's going to come down to who can get these good initiations in team fights. Looks like Niqua fishing for a hookshot here around the mid lane. Magicka will come.
They're baiting Puppy.
Oh, they went looking for it. The hookshot actually misses, possibly for the better. Pycat blinks in with a Hex. Puppy On his own, they made it a Sonic Wave. The Shackle Shot doesn't land. Nice. Overgrowth catches out S4. And meanwhile, Clockwork goes in on Kuro. Will not be able to bring him down. The Yule Scepter being used nicely there. Kuro unleashes his payload on Niqua, but doesn't get the kill. As elsewhere, they lose Wind Ranger and Bane. Two down on the side of Secret. And Pycat looking for more. Has a Blink available, but looks like Secret have dispersed and gone to the winds here to get the hell out of there. No RP used. And you mentioned, like, just how well they use their ultis. Lina used everything on a hero that the rest of his team weren't focusing. The Magnus couldn't get off an RP. Bane didn't get a chance to Fiend's Grip. They just didn't get a chance to use their ultis there.
Yeah, it was a very scrappy fight, and that's exactly what Alliance wants out of this game. Bristleback and Bop are going to do constant damage. Wisp is going to keep them alive, as well as Treant. And then Clockwork's just going to be more of a nuisance than anything for these cores of Team Secret.
Bristleback actually went back for a medallion as well, which is an odd choice for like one of your core heroes. I think he got this even after the Sanjin Yasha, I want to say.
Yeah, I didn't notice it until now. So
he at least had probably the Sanj.
He's got an interesting inventory. He's got his branch, casual gauntlet.
Yeah.
He probably just found the branch on the ground. He was like, oh, my TP's uncle, and I'll just pick this up.
I guess the Wisp is his little, I don't know, mobile TP scroll, I guess, but can TP him anywhere on the map.
Roshan's happening.
Yeah, so Secret have a smoked up Alliance team near them, but Alliance not making a move. Rocket Flare hasn't gone in and scouted this just yet. It looks like this is going down uncontested.
Rocket Flare.
It's too late. He had it for a while and was holding on to it, but perhaps not going to reveal his position while smoked up.
I just don't think they were sure of what was going on exactly.
After losing that Radiant Ward above the around the Ancients, it just the map got very dark for Team Alliance.
It did. And they did smoke into Roshan, I believe. So their one ward in the river here didn't spot it.
Okay, so Secret, I mean, that's a couple smokes in a row. They get a pickoff on a Clockwork, get a Roshan this time around, although
it's worth it, though.
Yeah, did lose that one team fight. Still feels like not much has changed as far as the state of this game. It's very much in the balance. Both teams kind of building up towards their kind of big game team fight. These late game team fight items are theirs. TC gets scouted out. He's got the Aegis, though. They don't want to overcommit. They're going to need a relocate in if they want to even kill him once, but here comes your Bane in the relocate now coming out. Kind of using a very defensive position here by Ake as well as Loda. Now there's your Fiend's Grip gets cancelled out by the Clockwork Hookshot. They're looking for that RP. Can they find a great Sonic Wave from Pycat? Goes through. Puppy finally gets brought down. Niqua, he force-stuffs himself into a shackle. Loda left alone. He didn't get relocated back out. And now Arteezy trying to hold on to this Aegis for a bit longer. Pycat coming in from the side. Loda finally gets the backup he needs from the Wisp. He's getting low though, down to 300 HP. There's another Shockwave and Alina stun in just a second. Solo RP on Loda. He goes down and it's just your Queen of Pain left standing. Pycat gonna get the hell out of there. A Secret win what I want to say is one of their first big teamfights of the game. Normally it's been these scrappy little pickoffs, but this time around they take a head-on teamfight against Team Secret.
Yeah, that fight was still pretty scrappy though. Like, Zai wasn't able to really find a good RP until the end there, and it was still just a solo kill of Bristle, which was good. Like, that was a good kill, but not the RP he was probably looking for. The root from Treant actually didn't go off that fight, and I think that was a big reason why the Clockwork ended up dying so quickly to the troll.
And he forced staff to dodge the Lightstrike array and then just set up that shackle as well, which was kind of unfortunate. But we'll see. S4 coming up big there, despite having a slow start and dying a few times this game. His team fight presence very much being highlighted there. So just the 4-star for your S4 Wind Ranger, but now we see the BKB on the troll, and that's going to be a 10-second BKB for your next team fight. So Sanjin Yasha, BKB, Helm the Dominator. Troll kind of just at that state of the game where he is going to be a big problem as far as dealing with this hero. And you mentioned you throwing empower on him suddenly. I mean, there isn't really a clear answer for Troll Warlord as a hero right now.
No, they're really going to need to make sure that this Treant gets his root off after the BKB just to stop his right clicks. But I think Alliance has probably missed their timing. Unless Secret takes a really poor team fight, I'm not sure they're going to be able to claw their way back into this game.
It's like, if you overgrowth him during the BKB, it doesn't feel like they have the damage to kill him anyway. So,
no,
yeah,
just
the BKB.
Wait for the BKB to go down and then just kind of kite him around.
Yeah. Well, the rest of the Secret team can kind of pack a punch too. Your Lina almost has an Aghanim Scepter. Kuro is the kind of silent carry of this team in some ways here. They are going to go on Arteezy. He's got the BKB. Is he going to turn and use it? There's an RP from your Magnus behind, but they've seen him. They're splitting up, not allowing an RP. Misses the skewer on the Wisp. It's going to be just load if he wants to use the RP. Defensive overgrowth, and it looks like neither team going to commit to this fight. Composure from Arteezy, who doesn't actually panic and use his BKB there, was trying to set up an RP for Zai, but didn't happen.
I think he's, he has almost no reason to use it against Bristle and Wisp. I think he's just saving it for the Clockwork or the Quap or maybe the Treant Root.
See, Magicka now coming in the jungle, finds Zai, hookshot from afar. Lina tried to maybe throw a stun there, the relocate coming in, and Zai hits a 4 here RP, but those cogs blocking everything off, and best RP we've seen, or at the same time, possibly one of the worst RPs we've seen.
Yeah. And it's the thought that counts, right?
Yeah. It's like you hit the 5 here at Black Hole, and there's no one else on your. Like, while you 4 of your teammates are dead. It's not really a good Black Hole.
Oh, good pick off there by Alliance.
It still feels like they need more of it. I mean, you mentioned just like the secret teamfight around the BKB troll. Yeah, even if Trolls just keeps on farming, if he gets his next level of items, the Skadi, the Satanic, dealing with him just gets trickier and trickier.
Yeah. But if they can get his BKB down to 5 seconds, then it shouldn't be that bad. Looks like they're going to try and defend bottom here.
Load of TP's in to start things off, and 4 other dots make their way down through the minimap, and looks like Secret aren't going to commit to this one. They've already started to make their way back to their jungle.
Yeah, no RP. Like, I think we're going to see a smoking gear from Alliance.
They haven't got that much. They've got good vision in the enemy jungle here, so especially if Secret make their way towards that jungle. Even if they don't, they get a pretty good picture of where Secret are on the map just by the fact they're not farming their jungle. So it looks like actually Alliance going to just kind of look to brute force this bottom lane.
Maybe he's fucking fine puppy before it.
Puppy. Can he see Nico here? The Sentry Ward, he's out of the range for it. Now he's going to start with the Battery Assault. Hookshot onto Puppy. Cogs to follow. He's locked in place here, but there's your lean up. Gets actually full stuff out of there. Nico wants out. The Sonic Wave goes through. Loader locked down by the Fiend's Grip. Can they cancel this? With the Overgrowth, they will. Tinky Winky goes down in the BKB. Great overgrowth from Magicka. There's no buybacks coming out from your Troll. He's got one, but he doesn't want to use it. And Puppy going to go down as well. Alliance killed 2, and a lot of that came down to the Treant Protector.
Also, PyCat managed to get his Hex onto Arteezy before the BKB happened, and that's why Arteezy was so low when he popped, when he came out of there. And he used his BKB instantly, and then just got rooted.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of, I guess, yeah, the Hex forces that panic BKB, and
it does. Yeah, that's probably why he went the item, actually. It was a really good item choice, I think.
Alliance now will be able to, look like, get this tier 2 bottom tower. Magnus has an RP, but he's just sitting on the high ground here, not looking to make a move out of this base, and this for just trying to delay things, or at least clear out the creep wave with some power shot spamming. Well, on top of this, PyCat now has a Lincoln Sphere, so he can play a bit more aggressive, not get caught up by a Yule's Initiation from Lina, a Shackle Shot from your Windranger. There's not really that many good spells for actually countering the Lincolns, outside of maybe like an Enfeeble.
Yeah, but if Puppy shows his face, I think Clockwork's basically Instagram every fight.
It's not really, yeah, it's exactly. It's only here you want in the front lines to initiate. I guess Magnus can just go in with like a blink RP to kill the Queen of Pain and then you deal with her for like that, but it feels like this is a really hard item to deal with if you're Secret.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's Zai's actually having a really tough time on the Magnus here trying to find RPs.
Oh, hookshot. Yeah. Catches out Kuro, he's gonna immediately throw up the Yules, but with the Battery Assault already cast, Nikwa likely to get this kill on Kuro. Kuro trying to find his way out. Who's gonna win the fight? It's gonna be Kuro, comes on top with the Ag Scepter. That's a new pickup. Gets the kill, and Lina may even survive this one. Scurries away down river. They do lose to Lina. Queen of Pain managed to clean that one up. PyCat coming in, and still a 2-for-1 trade going Alliance's way.
And Croaky is so farmed.
That's actually, I was just expecting Clockwork to get that kill, but then suddenly that's an Axe ulti.
2.5k above S4. How often do you see that?
Yeah. You see quite frequently, not frequently, but it's not a unheard of thing for a support to be more farmed out than like the offlaner, but
yeah, the mid hero though.
And it's a Lina, like I've seen like a Visage do it where they're like the number 2 most farmed hero, but something like a Lina is not a hero you'd expect.
Lina farms pretty quick though.
Yeah. Oh. I guess, I mean, this is why teams run Lina as a core, because you can get a lot out of the item progression. And S4 though, he's been in kind of struggle city, just working on an Ag Scepter now to go with his 4 staff.
Yeah.
So next Roshan in 2 minutes.
I haven't been paying too much attention to item progression, but Lotus almost got an Assault Kuros, which is pretty big for his team against Troll.
He's just going to the high ground at bottom lane, gets the Wiz support, forces some TPs, and Kuro gonna go looking for Aki here with this Yule Scepter. Not gonna find too much.
I think Team Secret should look to get a gem here pretty soon. The Treant Invis is kind of messing them up a bit.
Even just a lot of deep wards here. I feel like it's something they could have, they should have maybe even gotten earlier, would you say?
Yeah, well, in hindsight, of course, but...
yeah. The number of times there's been, like, a Nature's Guise initiation.
Just saying, let's try not to let the bad things that have happened happen again.
Yeah. So there's a gem for Alliance.
Yeah, map control would be super useful. They're actually starting to, they actually use their Treant Nature's Guise on their allies a lot. Like, he'll use it on the Clockwork, he'll use it on the co-op, and they just kind of like sneak up on Team Secret, so. They had a gem or something. Yeah. Maybe they saw him before it happened, that'd be good.
They've just had a couple of Sentry Wards, and that Sentry in that last fight was, he walked past it, but they didn't have vision, and then by the time he saw Puppy, he was out of the Sentry range, so.
Yeah.
Didn't really have the necessary coverage there. Now they're moving forward, but Alliance see all this. They've got the high ground ward. Hookshot in on Puppy to start things off, but the counter yields is there. No cogs comes out. Light Striker Ray onto Niqua. He may go down to this Laguna. Gets four star forward. That's not the direction he wanted to go. And in comes Loda. There's your overgrowth, and down goes your troll. Lockdown once more. Pinecap blinks forward, slows Puppy, and Loda. And the front lines has the completed AC. He's doing a lot of damage. Turns his back before he gets stunned up. That'll help him negate some of that damage. Skewer backwards. Treant. Uh-oh, he's in some trouble on the high ground here. They're living armor on himself. He gets gripped up and brought down, but his team is cleaning up. Loda in the front lines, just doing a lot of damage, and more importantly, Pycat. They've got it. He recovered, and now onto the tier 3 tower. Pycat just zoning heroes out.
Out of his bane. I think this is a set of racks. Unless we get a massive RP.
Oh, there's this shackle shot onto Niqua. They need another Laguna Blade if they want to fight this one. It looks like it's a solo RP on Pycat. Can they bring him down? They skewer him towards the tier 4 towers, but Pycat didn't even really come close to dying. He actually blinked back into a tower here. They lose the wind range in the meantime. Loda being dealt with by the Yules, but dealt with isn't really quite the situation here. They're going to lose bottom racks and... Oh, no, they're not. They back off. The wind range of buyback is enough to force them out. Niqua low, four stuff up in a couple of seconds. Gets the high ground cogs off and...
Uh-oh!
Misses that one. Four stuff! Come on! He's dodging, he's juking everything. He's got the four stuff, he doesn't want to use it apparently. He gets relocated out. Do they re-engage here? Bristleback is not headed that direction. It looks like they may just let the Wisp die.
I don't know, Bristle's got a haste rune.
He's not bringing back Claw. Oh, Aki looking for a tether maybe. No, oh, he gets out to the low ground. Well, that works. Alright, Secret can't even kill a Wisp. Whoa, where did this item come from? Pycat, refresher orb.
Holy moly, that's a refresher.
Secret immediately smoke up, probably have their eyes on Roshan or at least an advantageous teamfight, but Alliance knew where they were by the Roshan pit, and then they don't see them back off by this Observe Ward, so they may kind of figure out kind of what's going on here. They know they were bottom lane here, at least, like bare minimum.
Oh yeah, smoke from Secret. Roshan is up.
Will they go into the pit? Very dangerous. Clockwork, Rocket Flare, scouts it out, doesn't see anything going down.
They see Bristle Tree on, they're like, oh, fuck that.
Yeah.
Go the other way, guys.
Puppy walks into him. Uh-oh. Loda goes forward. One right click is a quarter of Puppy's HP, and Kuro's Lightstrike Array off the mark. Puppy taking big damage from Loda. Loda just marching on forward. There's your living armor once more. He gets one, and he's looking for more. Tinky Winky trying to fight Loda, but I don't think that's a fight he's going to win. Off to the side, Kuro takes a Sonic Wave, RP not being used, Pycat refreshes, hexes up Zai, blink in with a scream, Sonic Wave, misses the Sonic Wave, but it's still a victorious team fight. It's a celebratory ulti from Pycat. Well then, that is looking like an Alliance high ground push to come, and possibly bottom racks if they want it.
Definitely bottom racks. Zai's no buyback either, so maybe mid racks as well. Or... I think the smart play is they should go for Roshan. Well, actually...
Get the racks, it's worth it, but... No, neither it does, yeah.
Okay.
I guess they don't know the buyback status here. They see Bane respawning and think maybe, like, Bane respawns and a hero has buyback and then suddenly... we die.
Kroki's been rich the whole game. They can just presume that he has a buyback.
It will be the roast they go for.
Yeah, and Aegis on my cat, like, that's trouble.
He's being the playmaker. 11-2-10. This Queen of Pain play has been on point. Easy, Roshan. Uncontested. Hookshot in the mid lane. S4. He's got the 4-star. Uses it to the side. Gets away from the relocate in to some extent. But Lotus there with the nasally goo. S4 getting slowed down, but Loda won't commit. With 5 alive on the secret side.
Holy shit. You see that?
What did he Laguna?
The Wisp. The Wisp had 1 second on relocate. Lagooned him. It didn't do enough. He had that value vit booster. Actually, it's almost 3k gold. I think he should get the Vlad's for the bristle.
Yeah. Vlad's perks or
for like Yules or I mean luxury items, man.
Yule seems always good.
Get him back.
Not that much mana though, that's the problem.
Even just like a Yule's to keep the Magnus controlled in a team fight.
Yeah.
Just throw him up in the air and then you can deal with like kite around the RP a lot better, but at this point it doesn't really matter what you go. You could get a Dagon and it'd probably be I don't know if that would be a good item, but probably not, but we'll see them go high ground. Alliance, Loda on the front lines, working on the tier 3 tower with a DD rune.
They have Glyph for Team Secret, they're gonna use it here.
Need to. Loda just gonna get chipped away. He is not the one with the Aegis, so just be a little bit cautious. Get skewered back. They want to try keep him away from that Wisp relocate. Here it comes. Aki's gonna save his buddy. Perfect. Pulls him back. Good play. Just for a skewer though, they still will have another skewer in 20 seconds time, and there will not be a relocate. Aki, his relocate's gonna put him under this tower. This is actually kind of problematic. Forces them to engage. They go in with the hook shot. Starts things off on a puppy. Puppy's being getting locked down in place, and there's your Sonic Wave number one. Is there a number two? The refresh is still on cooldown. Loda, RP brought down, and Alliance, they're forced to retreat. They've only killed off the Bane with the Clockwork, and RTZ will bring down one more. That's a gem on the side of Team Secret now with that kill. A good hold for Secret. They're kind of forced to engage. It was a nice relocate save, but then the Wisp was like, I'm being relocated back into this space, so we've got to go in or we've got to let me die.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Like, going up high ground against Magnus is really tough, and that whole thing was set up from Zai initially skewering the Bristleback too deep into the tier 4s, and they had to kind of take a forced fight. And it's not like the scrappy fight that we talked about earlier. Like, this is exactly how Team Secret wants to take their team fights. They're just head on 5v5. And all the team fights earlier were, you know, a little bit more pick off-y and, you know, one on one kind of stuff like that. And that's where the co-op and the Bristleback really excel.
It also feels like Pycat with his refresh on cooldown was maybe like waiting out the refresher before a big team fight. They just wanted to chip away at the base and wait out that cooldown. Because if he had another Sonic Wave or another Hex, that could have been a much better fight for Alliance.
Of course. That being said, I think they're okay still.
Yeah.
They still have the Aegis on Pycat and can be a little bit smarter about the team fight that they select.
Tree and Aghanim Scepter going to be coming up soon too. That is quite the item.
Yeah, the thing is like, you see this item, but like, they've already like won the game, haven't they?
Yeah.
Don't you think like a mech and like a Vlad's would like you go like way farther with the 4,000 gold?
If you think so, I think so.
Oh.
I don't know. No, I think for like these most recent pushes, having a mech or a Vlad's could definitely have helped out. And Magicka's got the mana for it to use the mech, which you mentioned the Wisp is kind of limited on.
Exactly.
Wisp still hasn't spent his money. Is he picking up a Reaver and actually getting a heart? What an item. Relocate top lane. There's a fight breaking out. It was a Clockwork hookshot initiation, and Kura will be forced back to safety. Heart of Terrasse does not seem like the item for a Wisp, but I mean, it'll make him tanky, but seems
nice regen.
Seems very gimmicky.
Ah, it's not the worst item. Dagon would have been way worse.
Yeah, I agree. Touche, touche. So Shiva's now picked up for Pycat. His item progression continues to grow, and Team Secret down just one lane of Rax, but it does feels like the general state of this game is very poor for them. They haven't got any ability to control these team fights. They have got the gem on their side, and I believe, yeah, Puppy with the gem, so they won't be kind of caught up by surprise by these Nature's Guys initiations, but Alliance still with Aegis for just about 15 seconds. It looks like they won't get a chance to use it to try and push high ground.
Yeah. It's turning into the turtle fest we were talking about earlier. High ground defense with Magnus.
And this is even without, like, that sniper-type hero. I guess Troll kind of fits a similar category with his current items.
He's his own kind of monster.
It's where if you ever do skewer Bristleback away from the rest of his team, Troll, kind of, you lock, get him head-on with a Bristleback, you will lock him in place and kind of slow him down with the Sanjin Yasha plus Skadi slow, plus the bashes from Berserker's Rage. That is not easy for the Bristle to fight into.
Definitely not. But the issue is if they're going to die to Lina and Magnus before they even, like, start the fight.
Let's see. It looks like a BKB may come out next for your Bristleback.
That's a smart pickup, I think. I don't know. Need something, though. It's like, their high ground ability is just not good with Quap and Bristleback.
If it's on a BKB, it's like maybe a Heart of Tarrasque or something, just for raw HP.
I think BKB's fine, I'm not sure. I think they need another Roshan though for Quap. It's so hard to high ground, like, they just don't have, like, the best heroes to high ground. Like, they need to find a pick outside the base.
Yeah, Secret One, they can just stay inside their base, so that the picks maybe won't present themselves. They are making a move out towards this bottom lane, but feeling pretty confident they've got Vision and Soul where Alliance are on the map around that middle and top lane, so Teezy makes his move out. He's got buyback if needed. It looks like the buyback status is pretty good for this dire side.
Oh, here we go. Magnus is... He just blinked over today. They're going to go for it?
That is an aggressive play to be making here. They see everyone with this Raiden Observer Ward. They see the Troll. They saw the Magnus earlier. They're kind of converging towards these Ancients here. They deward it. Magicka also gets scouted out by the gem, and there's your hookshot. Catches Arteezy. He can beat KB, but he gets Hex first. The Sonic Wave goes through Kuro. Misses the stun, and Arteezy falls to just BKB and run. Doesn't want to turn and fight, and well, guess what? Magnus abandoned. What's a refresher from Pycat?
Has a buyback.
Ooh, hookshot catches Kuro. Fiend's Grip now being used as a countermeasure here. Niqua losing most of his mana pool to force up to the high ground, and Niqua trapped in his own cogs. He's going to be brought down. Aki, the relocate was too late. Oh dear, Dust forward, that's going to catch up Magicka, but it looks like they don't want to chase any further. The Magnus buyback was used. Oh, back comes Aki. Down he goes.
Not getting away this time.
Feels like Secret is still holding on, and you can... Troll Wallop, we've seen what this hero can do.
Just wait for the rubber band, it's coming.
Magnus plus Troll. All it takes is a fight or two, even just a single pickoff or two, as we just saw there. See a bit of a gold swing go back towards the Secret Favor, I imagine, in a few seconds on our graphs, but...
Yeah, and that's kind of the thing with this new patch. Like, before, you could kind of throw bodies at the racks here, and you could maybe you can get the mid-set of racks with a couple of buybacks on your heroes, but if they go mid and lose five or six heroes, like, they're going to lose the game.
That was the thing about so many TI4 games I remember. It's like, a team would do a bad push where they would, like, they'd go for the high ground with, like, a Death Prophet Void or whatever and get team wiped, and it's like, well, they just go again a minute later, and it didn't really hurt them that much. I mean, it hurt them, obviously, giving a bunch of some golden XP, but it's nowhere near what it is now.
Yeah, but then, like, Glyph would be on cooldown and stuff like that, and they could actually get the barracks, and then, you know, you felt, like, the progression of actually doing that. And now it's just, like... You die, and then their carry has like a whole new item. It doesn't even matter if there's mega creeps in the lane.
Roshan going to be a long respawn, kind of max duration respawn coming out, which... Yeah.
This is going to be the best opportunity for Alliance to take a team fight, because I think that Secret's going to want to contest this outside of their base, where they're much, much weaker.
Yeah, there's the BKB on Bristleback we talked about. Magicka's still short of 1,000 gold for his Accept, and this is where kind of you mentioned, like, you get a Vlad's or a Mech, he would have had an item which could benefit his team in these last few teamfights. Instead, he just has some extra stats. I guess his big spell has been the Overgrowth, but even, like, a Blink Dagger so he could get in faster, maybe, but... Or this Axe is... I mean, it's kind of like he could have bought an item to increase the Radiant team's advantage when they were strong, because right now their lead seems to be faltering a bit.
Yep. I'm telling you, man. Axe tree. Not the way to go, I think.
It seems good when you're playing from behind, and, like, you're just for an item that you're fighting with, but with the advantage, it seems like maybe you can go other directions. Bottom lane Puppy very aggressively positioned. Blink Hex comes out, and easy one pick off here. Can they get number two? Kuro gets caught by the Overgrowth, uses himself in the air, but looks like he may go down here. Throws out a Laguna Blade, and accepts his own fate. Nice two hero shackle, but that's just going to cover the retreat here. It's a hook shot from Niqua, locking Arteezy inside the cogs here. Niqua getting kind of low, but the overcharge from Aki negating most of that damage, and that's your Lina buyback.
I think they lost their gem as well.
There was a gem on the ground, and it looks like it was recovered by Majka. It was originally his gem, but it went over to the side of Secret, and now it looks to return to its original owners.
There we go. There's a ward and a sentry on this high ground here for Secret. Just see everything that was happening.
So next Roshan very that soon.
That's a 12-minute, or isn't that like a 11-minute Rosh?
Yeah, I see it like right on the dot, so it's probably pretty much at that point. Relocate top, just going to farm and push things out with the Bristleback Wisp. Try and get some creep equilibrium control. Secret know this Rosh respawn's coming, and it looks like they do want to contest it. They've got all their big ulties, but they've got to land them. They're very reliant. They're going to deward and then immediately smoke up.
This is it, man.
This is the big Roshan fight. Loader going to be the one they run into. Can they bring him down? There's no relocate to save his life if they do kill Loader, but they see Loader and they say, no, 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 no. Let's get out of here. We do not want to fight this guy.
Got that fresh BKB.
You can't grip him either because Nico's always going to be there with a hookshot, so...
Yeah.
You can't rely on that grip to keep him in place. The clockwork pick has really been big for Alliance really this game. Secret now, they scout this out, they get a power shot, rocket player will get vision of Team Secret. They deward the high ground ward, so...
Oh, Triant.
Oh. So scared.
And this is just aggressive play from Magicka. It looks like the Hex comes out on the side. Nice full stuff. We'll push Arteezy back. He's got the BKB, gonna turn and fight. He gets locked in place. There's your overgrowth. Sonic Wave, they can't attack even in the BKB. Arteezy's gonna try Satanic and bring down Loader. He's life-stealing a bit back of HP. No one dead just yet. Hookshot forward from Niqua. Catches out Kuro as well as pushing back Arteezy. Again, it's a huge RP! Arteezy gonna clean up! Didn't even... It had the Empower as well. That's three dead on the Alliance side. Insta buybacks coming out. They want to fight this one. Hookshot in on Puppy. Gets full stuff back. He goes down to the Pycat. Queen of Pain. Blink forward available soon. And Pycat may be able to finish off S4. He's trapped in the trees here. Four stuff. TP. Can S4 get out? It looks like he might. No hookshot being used. And S4 will survive. That's the RP Secret we're looking for.
Yeah, it's just tough to fight this late game troll for Team Secret. The Empower plus RP combo, just too strong. They need to make sure this RP doesn't go off. And Bristleback can't even man fight troll anymore.
Such a long fight, and Azai just kept on waiting and waiting and waiting, and he finally got the RP. But Alliance used buybacks, knowing RP's on cooldown. They say, look, we'll use buybacks, push him away, and then get the Aegis. So Aegis at least goes the way of Alliance's side, but
that's true. The good thing is that Secret didn't get the Aegis, so that would have been a real problem for them.
We'll see some item progression out of Secret as a result of that team fight, though. And I guess the other thing you kind of mentioned is getting the Troll's BKB down. It's down to 5 seconds now for Arteezy, so that can be entirely negated by the Overgrowth, effectively, if timed properly by Magicka.
He's been doing a pretty good job about it. Just waiting patiently for it.
Do you get like a last item Manta style if you're troll to get out? Or do you like disassemble your Sanjin Yasha for Manta even?
I mean, it's not the worst idea, but I don't know if he's going to do that. He's probably just going to look for more damage.
Alliance going to group up towards the top lane. It looks like they want to go for a push. They've got a couple smokes coming out as well. The Vanguard of Loader can be sent back to base and Secret. Still looking to work on some tier 1 towers. They've taken one tower this entire game. Puppy Hex up at top lane. Pycat. Just trying to force out some TPs and rotations. Meanwhile, it's mid lane. Loader getting the tier 3 tower. And you get zoned back by your Troll Warlord. Just some kind of split push coming out with the Queen of Pain at top and the Bristleback in the mid lane. Keeping Secret spread thin. Well, Team Secret, this is the high ground defense. This is it. This is where Alliance get tested. Whether they can breach the high ground or not is going to be the big deciding factor for this game, it feels like. Because they've got the Aegis, they've got all their big core items. It doesn't really get much bigger or scarier than this. But for Secret, it does. You put like a Refresher on a Magnus, you put a damage item on S4, who's now picked up a Crystallis. Things can change very quickly.
Yeah, just It's so tough. It's such a hard game for Alliance to finish.
Top lane now, they're going to position in. They're going with the Blink Hex here. It's Arteezy again that they want to jump on, but the full staffs of Secret keep them safe, and Alliance can be forced to reset once more.
The Skewer.
They're going to go for it. The Blink Skewer's there. Loader gets pushed back, and there's going to be a relocate in as well. A relocate out, thinking that it was in some trouble there. Clockwork, hookshot, forced after the low ground. Loader gripped up during BKB. No cancel as the hookshot's still on cooldown. But neither team taking any casualties. Bit of an odd fight there. Aki reset, means... reset. Yeah, reset. No relocate this time around. Another nightmare. Is there another Skewer? Zai, 7 seconds away from that Blink Skewer play. See if he looks to go for it now, especially with that relocate on cooldown. And Loader doesn't have a BKB, he may have an Aegis, but if you can kill him really deep inside your base, cause some problems. Hookshot. Oh, that's going to catch out one on the side. Overgrowth catches out three. Arteezy locked in place. He's also hexed up. Can't BKB out just yet. Now he's going to BKB, but the mag is dead. Loader taking heavy damage here. He's getting overcharged up, and Aki healing him, keeping him alive. Loader won't die. He's still alive. Aki just healing him, being the medic, and Arteezy now in trouble. No BKB, no Satanic. No, he's got the Satanic. He's going to turn and fight, bring down the Aegis, move on to Aki. Harder Trask helping him out a bit here. Is it going to do enough here? Arteezy's back to full HP. They're going to buy back the Magnus now. RP still on cooldown for 70 seconds. Two Hero Shackle. S4 Windranger in action. Niqua now slowed down. Doesn't get the hookshot out. Two dead for Alliance. And in the mid lane, it's Pycat trying to work on the Range Tracks. Blink Skewer. They're going to glyph it as Queen of Pain. Blinks to the side here. Chill trying to finish off the Range Tracks. The Blink on cooldown for a couple more seconds. Shackle not going to latch. And it looks like they're going to get the Queen of Pain back to safety. Back in the top lane. It's the Rat Lords. Alliance chipping away at the tier 3 tower, doing what they can to be pesky and just poke away at this team secret base. Feels like an okay fight for Alliance. They lose 3, or they lose 2 plus an Aegis, but they get some structural damage on the secret base.
Yeah, it was okay. I mean,
no one wins, no one loses.
Yeah, the high ground defense of team secret is just
too good. But they got, so they almost got the range barracks mid, the tower top is getting pretty low. Treants, I think he did. He finish his hour-long Agon of Scepter? No, not. He's halfway.
He's been halfway for half an hour. It feels like.
Got it. Range barracks.
All right.
He got.
He has got. Okay, he had 10k gold. Dagon 5. Here we go.
That's nice. That was good. He can burst Bane and Lina or whoever.
Even the troll with the fire, I guess maybe not burst the troll, but have some extra damage.
Troll's not dying, man. Just get that out of your mind. That hero's invincible. Well, pretend he's like a mobile fire bush, okay?
It's kind of what. That's a good comparison. I haven't heard that before, but it does kind of feel that way. With the Daedalus, he hits like a fire bush.
Yeah.
Loda, Abyssal Blade.
That's good.
It's nice. Feels like still got the one item slot as well. Holding onto the cheese for now, but
this is a blind smoke gank though. But they have, I mean, they see
control. Do they go on him? Queen of Pain with a fresh Dagon 5. Hookshot in. They've got no refresh on the quad. They're going to start with the hook and Arteezy. Full sauce forward. Doesn't do the most with the cogs here. Niqua trying to see what he can do. Tinky Winky's going to be the target here. The Laguna Blade used to counter. Sonic Wave not bad from Pycat. Gets the Magnus. No buyback, no RP, hard fight for Team Secret, and now Arteezy locked in place, but BKB's out of the overgrowth, trying to fight Loader. Great hookshot from Niko, but he gets Fiend Script up. Nothing to cancel this. Magicka's just going to stand and watch as they lose their clockwork, but that's a dead S4 Windranger. May force out the buyback here. Pycat moving forward, blinks to the west as he gets out of there. That's 3 dead on Team Secret's side. Arteezy forced to scurry away. He gets Lincoln's up by Kuro. As they want to focus down this melee racks now. Secret, buyback on their Windranger. Loader in some trouble. Has a cheese available. Gets the Shackle Shot. Can he even pop this? Is the Bash RNG there? You betcha! Loader, no cheese for you! S4 gonna be a dieback though as Queen of Pain blinks the high ground. Refreshes the blink! Pycat gets out. Turns with a Hex. Sonic Wave. Dagon 5. Arteezy still alive and kicking. Has that Satanic and can heal back up if they have to go on him. And he'll use on the creeps. You're right. He's not dying.
He's definitely not dying, man.
They're just gonna rat it out. That's the plan.
Monster of a hero.
Well, we're seeing
Volvo,
this.
Please.
I mean, I'd say Queen of Pain looking like a monster of a hero as well. Not quite the same, just brute force of the Troll Warlord, but some flashy plays coming out of Pycat here.
got a hex, doesn't he?
Oh, no, Bristle no. Back. It's a relocate. They're going to buy back the Bristle. They want to kill off Arteezy. Oh. He's going to BKB, though. Can he go in and fight? It looks like the answer is probably yes. He brings down the Wisp, and Loda may be in some trouble. This was a buyback for your Bristle back. He's going to be careful. Has the cheese available? Will he get a chance to use it this time? Does look so.
Watch the iron base for RP.
Uh-oh. Pycat, he's ratting it up. There's your blink RP. Can they kill him off? Skewer into the Troll Warlord. Pycat going to go down here. That's a big kill. They stopped going for the Bristleback just to make sure they kept their base alive. It was just distraction tactics coming out from Loda just to create space for Pycat to get that tier 3 tower, but they still got Rack standing. We're going to buy some boots of travel, and let's see what we can do, Team Secret. It feels like they've got to go, and got to go soon.
Alright, so think if you're Alliance, I think you're waiting for Bristle's buyback and another Roshan. Unfortunately.
And if you're Team Secret, are you trying to go before those come back up, or are you still just high ground defense for days?
Not sure. I think you have to try and contest the Roshan, maybe? See how that goes? But...
It'll come up before the Bristle buyback. That's the good news.
Yeah. Yeah, they're gonna have to contest the Roshan.
Alright. Let's see, maybe if they can look to secure themselves. Bristle, another, DD rune.
Another pretty late Rosh spawn.
Yeah. Unfortunately for Team Secret, who may have been able to control that one, especially with Pycat dead, they could have likely gone in and tried to make a play, or at least just take a Roshan. Man, Zai is poor, though. His Magnus not really finding the RPs, and just a blink 4-staff it.
I think he's bought back, like, at least twice.
Yeah. Two, maybe three times, and... Well, Secret gonna get this. Well, are they gonna get their second tower of the game? This has been a very tough game for them to push down towers. That's where the Tree and Protector has really paid off as a hero, and...
Don't do it, Niqua.
Oh, relocate top! They want this range Rax. They're gonna fight through the backdoor protection.
Is a DD.
Rat Dota. It's not an Alliance game without a bit of Rat Dota. S4 gonna... Oh! Gets the Windrun off. That's barely gonna save his life. Overgrowth now comes into play. BKB out. They're gonna try final Loda. They kill him off! No buyback for your Bristleback! Meanwhile, Treant. Gonna get punched.
That's some game losing shit right there. I like to see it. You know, you gotta get creative against the ball sometimes.
I love how you're... I just hear you laughing in the background as I'm casting. Like, I'm
wait. Okay. Remember that 3-hour-long game?
Yeah.
And Envy died with no buyback and the game was just ended.
Yep.
That was like the funniest moment in Dota history this month.
It's one of those like, things. It takes just that one slip up to end the game.
As long as you're not the one throwing the game, it's pretty funny. But I think they're okay though. Maybe. They're gonna lose a lot of buildings here.
Tier 1s, tier 2s, but nothing vital. I mean, you could lose a lane of Rax and Alliance still would be at least still in an okay position.
Yep. Just the limbs, right?
Yep. Well, I mean, you've still got a Magnus with no refresher up. That's pretty good news for Team Alliance. Range Rex back to full HP. The backdoor protection healed it up. Tinky Winky at top. He's getting chain stunned here. Refresh, double hex. Down goes Arteezy.
Got him.
It's fire bushes can die. We've seen that at least back in the Dota 1 days.
Yep.
Why isn't that introduced in Dota 2, man? That was like the ultimate insult. It was when you killed the enemy Firebush.
Then you're just permacamped.
In Alliance, patrolling the sidelines. Got a bit greedy there going for those extra towers, but... I mean, at this point, Arteezy is more or less 6-slotted. Doesn't really have much more he can do. We mentioned mate. I don't know. Do you feel like the Sanjin Yasha over the Manta style is the way to go? I mean, or is it even something bigger or scary that you want to go for?
I could swap them out. Could go Butterfly as well. But he's actually, like, you saw he died to all magic damage there too, yeah. So.
It's tough.
I don't pick Troll very often, but.
It's good to hear.
Butterfly is probably okay. I don't know.
Feels like the big thing he's going to need is like the Lincolns from Kuro on him can help protect him from some of these hexes. Sure. Even if it forces Queen of Pain just to throw a Shadow Strike to break it, like that's time wasted. And like even just during that cast time, you can react.
Or you could get a Divine.
Ooh, I like the idea of Divine. You mentioned Roche contest. Looks like Secret. not going to be in the neighborhood for this one. They're going to just bank everything on their high ground defensive capabilities. Zai has got that magic buyback this time.
There's 2 minutes till Glyph. I don't know if... I'm sure they probably took a timer of the Glyph. They might try and make something happen. Where that comes back up.
Puppy scouting things out very aggressively. It's a Fiend's Grip on Matsuko. He's actually completely alone. That's just a free pickoff. No relocate. There we go. Took that extra bit of time.
He would have tree armored and stick and spam bottle. I think he would have lived. Oh no. He would have got brain sapped probably. Oh, another DD rune.
Oh. We'll see if they pass this over. I guess Loader would have to drop something pretty big to get this, so. Are they going to drop like a Sanjin Yasha?
You just trade items. You swap the Wisp and like. You'd give SNY to a Wisp.
Or your even your boots.
Pop the bottle.
He's just gonna pick it up. Do they relocate in? Do they make another attempt on that range Rax?
Oh no no no.
One failure was enough.
Well, I don't think Lord has buyback yet, does he? Got a minute cooldown, so.
Okay. So Zai, instead of buyback, has picked up a Shadow Blade here, and well, gem detection is non-existent on this Radiant side. This is actually a pretty big item to pick up right now.
It's gonna help him. It's gonna help him get behind the Bristleback. That was the biggest problem in this game, is the Bristleback's just on the front line and he's always getting hit by quills and can't really just get in there. So if he can Shadow Blade through the Bristle and then maybe find people in the back, maybe what he's gonna want to try and do.
So Pycat up to some kind of covert operations down here in bottom lane, just blinking from tree spot to tree spot. Is he going in on this troll wall? They could relocate in and go for this kill, but a risky play to try and make.
Oh, is he gonna go for the next wave?
The eyes.
Eyes.
Oh, he's just out of range, actually. The Radiant Vision doesn't spot him. It's top lane where a fight's breaking out. Loader, the one who's been nightmared up, there's gonna be a relocate. Just. Oh!
Oh, RP.
Oh, dear.
What's that buyback? He does. Thank you.
Is he even taking Loader with him? Yeah, he is. He's gonna fight this one. They BKB, the Fiend's Grip is there, the hookshot. No, it's gonna be a hex on a puppy. That'll cancel it. Great! Sonic Wave goes flying through. There's a second Sonic Wave if Pycat wants to use it. He'll do so. S4 getting low, trying to turn and fight, but Loader with the Wisp Tether being kept alive. Overgrowth now comes into play. Arteezy locked in place. He can't Satanic, he can't attack. Buybacks are plenty for Secret. They're gonna buy back the Windranger, buy back the Troll. This is it. No RP makes this difficult, though. Zai only has a skewer back, pushes Pycat into the rest of the team, but they've got no follow-up lockdown. They can't keep these Alliance heroes in place, except with the S4 Shackle. Loader, it's gonna be just the Aegis for now. Unlikely we see a second kill. Wisp is there with a tether. They're gonna hookshot in, bring down your Lina. No buyback for Kuro, it looks like. Loader now on the front lines. He's looking to just brute force his way through Team Secret. As Arteezy on the front lines has got that Manta style now, but it's Pycat on the back lines. Dagon 5 brings down your Bane, then he blinks out. Hookshot gonna catch out Zai. Niqua making some plays happens. This constant hookshot spam and... Oh, Arteezy can't keep up with the clockwork, getting blocked out by the cogs. Arteezy in the front lines, he's just getting kited around, finally gets his BKB back up. They're just focusing down the Rax though. The range Rax is dead, the melee taking damage, Arteezy still alive and kicking. It's Loader who's just focusing the melee, looks like he will get it. Mega creeped! Team Alliance, don't take too many casualties. They're gonna buy back the clockwork. Zai, no RP still. Blinks forward after Pycat, looking to get this kill here. Skewer back, that's gonna be on Magicka. Overgrowth on 2, and where's that Manta style? We'll get out of the overgrowth, but GG, Throne goes down. Alrighty, game one in the pack.
That was a real barn burner.
That was, I mean, we talked about the scrappy fights, which seemed to work out pretty well for Alliance all throughout the early game, and they end things in pretty scrappy fashion.
I think you handled that last team fight pretty well.
Yeah, it was. I don't know what the hell was going on, man. That was just. I didn't see the Throne get hit, but apparently Creeps won the game.
The action wasn't there, man. The action was in the team fight, and you killed it.
Thanks. I'm glad to have your seal of approval. You killed it as well, man. It's great to have you on the analysis for the co-cast, and well, we've got game two coming up. We'll see if it's as interesting as this game one, but that was quite the performance from Pycat on the Queen of Pain. That was impressive.
Queen of Pain first pick next game?
Possibly. I mean, it seems to be a hot contested pick here between these two. If not first pick, first pick by maybe the team who has second pick, I guess, but we'll see. But we'll take a break, guys. When we come back, Starlight of Europe continues. I'm God Streaming as PPD. We've got Secret versus Alliance, game two, coming your way.